So this setup looks kind of weird, but because I'm on Slayer Taz, I'm actually going to use the Slayer Helm, not the actual full set. So believe it or not, each piece has its own percentage boost. So if you have the whole set, it's 50% damage. But individual pieces, I think 3% each. So I get 15% damage from the helmet, and then I get 6% on the body and the legs. So the crystal ball is actually still gonna get an extra damage or two bonus on the Sire, you know, on top of the Slayer Helm. So I'm gonna just do a quick test to see what this max hit is right now. Ooh, yeah, 38. Yep. Because it was, I think, 36. Hold on, it was 36. Yeah. Because we figured that out as well. So with the Slayer Helm, I get 38. So that's nasty, dude. Shit. Really destroy those Sire Fence, man. 38 on the Sire Fence, easy 2 KOs, man. If you didn't know, the Crystal Ball is actually one of the best weapons to use against the respiratory systems because you can attack the respiratory system from so far away, saving you time from all this running. And also, you save scales over the blowpipe. And I would argue it's best in slot, period. Especially with this new Crystal Armor set effect, which brings your max hit from a 36 to a 38, so you can easily 2-8 KO the respiratory systems. I will also prove to you how good it is in the video by showing the test runs of the crystal ball with the new armor set. Oh, that's it. This is a 38. Yeah, dude, nice. That was beautiful, man. Nice. Killed all four in one rotation, just like that. Happened sooner than I thought. That was nasty, dude. Yeah, Scythe is pretty sick here. When you lower its defense a good amount, absolutely smashes. Oh, this is disgusting. I just killed all four vents in one rotation, and I still probably have like 3 shots left. That was nasty. That's the third one that I've done today. I just hit a 96 with my claws. Holy shit. That was insane. 48 base, that means yeah, another 48 stack on the other thing. I just discovered something really amazing about how the crystal armor works in terms of how the charges work. So I was thinking, you know, it could work like the crystal shield where it only loses a charge if you actually take a 1 or higher, right? So when I'm killing respiratory systems, I'm not taking any damage at all. There's nothing that is attacking me. So after about 2 hours of using a crystal armor as Sire, I checked my charges. I was at 2347 when I started, and then 2 hours later, I'm still at 2347. That's insane. So there is literally zero cost when using a crystal armor here. This has crazy connotations for other PVM, specifically Hydra, because that's one of those bosses where if you do your purrs correctly, you don't take any damage. This is really good for people that do Sire. If you don't want to leave the restores and brews behind as drops, you can actually pick it up. And on your way to your house while you're healing up and all that, you can just get your butler to do it for you, as you can see. Super useful. Alright, I just actually finished an hour of the Sire with the new crystal armor. And I also incorporated a full hour sight. This is a perfect hour. We got 25 kills as Sire in an hour. That's actually insane. If I remember vaguely, I remember doing this boss back when the Sammy Hosta was like best in slot, and I think it was like 15 kills an hour or something. Alright, I just did an hour out of curiosity of just using the Art Light, because I never really compare the two, so now I have this opportunity to. So I got 24 kills an hour. So the Scythe isn't really that much better. Arguably maybe 1 or 2 kills an hour more. 2 kills a stretch, maybe just like 1 extra kill, honestly. So what is the verdict of the crystal armor top and bottom with the crystal bow SR? freaking amazing, dude. I definitely got probably one or two more sire kills because of, you know, how fast I did the respiratory system. And it costs no charges to use on the armor. There's no excuse to not use it. It is certified best in slot. Oh, that was so easy, bro. Damn. So easy, bro. All right, so the last place that I'm pretty confident the crystal armor is really good at that I haven't done it yet is Hydra. So we proved successful at the Sire. We will prove successful with the crystal armor at Hydra. All right, so this is the new setup with the crystal armor Hydra. Because as you can see, I'm still insanely accurate. I lose 6 compared to Armadale, but I gain a total of 3 extra prayer. So that's pretty nice for a 6 accuracy cut. So pretty worth it. Hydra's Fang, what the hell is that? Oh wait, that's for the ring. Yeah, I guess we're going to make our third Brimstone ring. Not, you know, not that crazy or anything, but yeah. Using the Crystal Armor Hydra, I did, I think, like 30 kills, and I used about 100 charges. So that means I've taken 100 hits. Ooh, Hydra's Heart. Hey, I just finished my third Brimstone ring, dude. Lit. Yes, make myself my third Brimstone ring. Nice. Oh, shit. Nice. I just got a freaking Hydra's Claw, dude. Pog. What the hell? I just got 3 redwood tree seeds. They're not worth a whole lot, but damn, that's insane, dude. I'm actually gonna include these into my tree runs, probably, that I do late night. Oh, another chemical Hydra head? Jesus. Man, these things are not that rare. Yeah, that's for sure. Whew. Oh, my God. I squeezed and trapped the lightning so freaking clutch there. That was actually insane. All right, I have finally finished this Hydra task. I think it was 160 or so. And yeah, let's check how many charges I've used. So we started at about 2,400. And it's one shard every 100 charges, right? So I've used 400 on the top, 400 on the bottom. And that equates to 8 shards. Literally one Corrupt Gauntlet game or like maybe two, three Sokano games. My final verdict for the Hydra Armor of Hydra is that it is best in slot. I would definitely use this over Armadale because my kill times are pretty much the same. And I get to make my prayer pots last a little bit longer. And also very minimum shard use. Oh, what another fucking champion scroll. My 15th one. Okay. Oh, Elite Clue Scroll from the KBD. Nice. Because they just don't give me anything, you know? Oh, fuck. Oh, I have rune bolts. We're chilling. Damn, I used 100 Dragon Diamond bolts already. Jeez. Luckily for me, I picked up some Runite bolts. Oh shit, another Mimic. Guys, this is insane. Alright, we got a Mimic. Clue number 5, here we go. So I actually found another place that I could use the Blade of Salder for. And it's at actually the Smoke Devil boss. No joke. So I usually use the Garazi Rapier, but the Salder Blade is technically a little bit better, not by a whole lot, you know, just a little bit better than the Garazi Rapier. It has a 11 stab resistance and it has a 4 slash resistance, so I'm a bit more accurate, you know, with the Salder Blade. So yeah, man, I got charges for days anyway, so not really worried about running out. Definitely gonna do a task with this at least. Ooh, smoke battle stab, nice. Boom, you know, AFK galore, man. I wouldn't do it now. I don't think I would do it anymore. Because it was so good when I was at school, Amethyst mining was so good for schoolwork. God damn, I just absolutely obliterated this guy. Jesus Christ. Alright, just a full task with the Salder Blade here. And wow, it's actually noticeably a bit better than the rapier. I wasn't sure because honestly, the defense difference between slash and stab here is like only, you know, 6 or 7. But I would probably continue to use this until I'm feeling a little worried about my shards. But realistically, I have so many shards anyways. I'd be alright for a long time, but yeah. What the hell? This freaking level 111 Misty Sue just came out of nowhere and crashed me, dude. Alright, I'm out of here. I don't want to get bullied, so. Today's a big day, potentially. 565. I have 28 keys, so that'll get me really close to 600. We will have clear the 5 times rate. Alright, last key. I will go free to play, sure. 590. So that's it. Officially 5 times rate, and also gonna be going past that. Alright, boys and girls, my bone crusher necklace is starting to get kind of low. I mean, 22,000 is a lot, but let's be honest, guys, I've already used like 80,000 charges. So, I think it's time for me to, you know, start worrying a little bit. Alright, I just did all my buckets for today. How many of these tokens do I get? Oh, 130. Okay, so what are we looking at here? Oops, a forehead. Alright, let me put it here. Oh, so every day I can get an extra 3,000 charges. No problem. I don't even have to do this much. Okay, well, this is pretty screwed because, unfortunately, it's probably going to heal the boss. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Oh my god, no, that's awesome. It actually worked. Alright, we're starting to incorporate some divine pots into Grotesque Gardens as well. Let's just say the divine pots, I mean, you know, being max potted all the time, it's definitely gonna help me here, just because sometimes, you know how it is with orb skips, it just gets kind of close, and you know, every little bit of DPS missing could really make or break the orb skip. So okay, I just got a number of 50 lucky impling thanks to good food. But yeah, we'll open these one day, but I'm still low-key hoping for the buff that they're going to do to this. All the area-only Ironman is going to be jealous of my lucky M stack that I've saved throughout the years. I haven't been doing a lot of it, though, but, you know, every time I get a chance that I do catch them. Maybe we get something cool from one of these. Might finish it. Yes! That was so clutch. KO that thing on the last hit. Whoa, I just got almost 1,000 mithril ores from one kill. 959 that kill, wow. Yeah, not bad. And this is about 600k GP, so I made about 4.9 mil this trip. So, ooh, the big boy 600. At the Socano. 150 more for the raid. Damn! Oh wait, I just got a 32 runite ore drop in a 4-man? What the hell? That's fat. 320 rune darts. Actually, I should leave soon. I gotta make some steel. And make some- Oh! Oh my god, dude! No way! Someone got the fucking tool seed. Oh, damn. Oh, I know, I always think I get it, dude. I always think I get it. But, wow, that's like my 4th, 5th one I've seen so far in 669. Damn. He doesn't even know what that is! Bruh, you made bank! Man, what do you mean you don't know what that is? Oh, shit, someone got the pet. Wow, that's insane, dude. Holy shit, congrats, man. First time I've seen that. Wow. Damn, dude. I'm used to it now, you know, knowing that if I see the green, it's not my name. I didn't freak out on that one, dude. 700 KC. 700. That's a pretty crazy milestone, man. Damn. Looks like we're gonna have to earn the crystal tool seed the hard way. Oh, there we go. It didn't take too long. We already got the task. Alright. So We got ourselves a basilisk test. That means, you know, as soon as I finish the quest, then yeah, we are able to kill some basilisk knights for the best chance at that face guard component drop, you know, for the new helmet. Alright, well, we got the first kill going. We got 20 keys basically today, and of course, we start with some root plate legs. 600! Oh my god, we got mossy keys. Alright, well, we hit the 600 now, so we got rewarded with a mossy key. Alright. Alright, last key, guys. This is it. 600. Oh my god. Alright. I guess I'm just gonna have to get it after TwitchCon, so. By the time you guys watch this video, I will have flown over to California. Reason why I'm there is to attend TwitchCon with some friends and some content creator friends, and also to spend some time with some family after TwitchCon for a few days around the area. Much needed break, to be honest. But yeah, the content will slow down for a bit, but once I'm back in about a week, I will be grinding out the new quest, Freemanic Exiles, and also try to get the new Natus Knot face guard as well, the new Best Assault Melee Helm. So I'm really excited for that. If you are new to the channel and you want to stay up to date with progress, make sure to subscribe and ring that bell. Also, my friends chat is always open 24/7, so if you guys need a place to hang out and just, you know, talk and pass the time while you grind RuneScape or actually get some help about RuneScape things, there's tons of cool people in there that it's glad to talk to you and also help you out. And that's about it. I hope to see you guys soon with another video as soon as I can make one. Take care and bye bye.